Hello students, in last video we already studied the cultural majors. So in this video we will study the physical majors. Actually the physical majors, there are some physical factors. We are using those physical factor for eradication of the insect as well as the non-insect pest. So there are many physical methods which involves the manipulation of the temperature, humidity, and use of the radiant energy, and all these methods which are particularly useful for destroying the stored grain pest particularly. Okay, so here the first physical measure or method, that is the low temperature. We know that every living organism required a proper temperature, okay, and that temperature which must be suitable, okay, for the proper growth and development. So if the temperature is suitable, then and then only the living organism will grow properly. Otherwise, if that particular suitable temperature is not available, if the temperature increases or decreases, it will affect on the growth and development of that particular living organism. So by considering that factor, we are just use the low temperature. Actually the low temperature, they are not so effective as compared with the high temperature in killing the insects, but still practically we are using this method of low temperature for controlling the insect pest. Now if the temperature is below 40 degree Fahrenheit and the storage food products, we are also just stored below the 40 degree to 60 degree Fahrenheit, then it is useful for killing the different types of the insect pest. Because this it is just low temperature that is not required for the proper growth and development. If the temperature is again lower and if it is near to the freezing point, in that case also the either the temperature below from 40 degree Fahrenheit, and if it is near to the freezing point, it just will prevent the insects, okay, in all the stages to grow and develop. Means in short, we can say that the lower temperature will prevent all the insect damage. Okay, so here if the temperature lowers, the activity of the insect stops and the insects, they become inactive, okay, and the period of exposure, which is depend on the species of the insect. Now see the lower temperature, how it affects on the activity of the insect. We are just taking the example of the human being. Baga ata aplyakade kontha season chalu aahe, winter season chalu aahe, okay, hivala chalu aahe. Jar ata hivalyamade baga tumhi jar roz 5:30 6 la uthat asal, तर समर सीझन मधलं टेम्परेचर 5:30 6 ला तुम्ही सहज उठू शकता, पण विंटर मध्ये म्हणजे हिवाळ्यामध्ये जर तुम्हाला 5:30 6 ला उठायला लावलं तर कंटाळा येतो. का? कारण टेम्परेचर इतकं लो असतं हिवाळ्यामध्ये पर्टिक्युलरली, ओके. मग ह्या लो टेम्परेचरमुळे आपण काय बनतो, इनॲक्टिव्ह बनतो. सो इन द सेम वे, इफ द टेम्परेचर डिक्रीजेस, द इन्सेक्ट्स दे बिकम इनॲक्टिव्ह इन द लो टेम्परेचर. अँड सिन्स वी आर युझिंग दीज अ टेक्नॉलॉजी फॉर controlling the pest population, particularly in the in case of the stored grain pest. Okay, so this is the first point, that is the low temperature. Then the second point, that is superheating. It is exactly opposite to that of the low temperature. Here we are going to increase the temperature. So if we are increase the temperature from 110 degree Fahrenheit to 150 degree Fahrenheit for the few minutes, actually this higher temperature is responsible for killing the insect directly. See, this method is very simple, and many years ago we are using this method of superheating. So superheating means what? See, when we are just taking any food grain, and if that food grain is get infested by the stored grain pest, we are just keep that particular food grain in the sunlight, and due to the increased temperature, the insects they get killed. Okay, same technique we are using here, that is known as the super heating. So this higher temperature, we are using this higher temperature, 110 degree Fahrenheit, 215 degree Fahrenheit, for few minutes. And if we increase the temperature for few minutes, it is responsible for killing the insects. So this method of increased temperature means the superheating method we are using in case of the insects which are present in the cereals or in some seeds. Okay, then the Mediterranean fruit flies. In case of the fruits like the oranges, grapes. Okay, for controlling the insect pests which are attacked on the oranges and grapes, we are using this particular method of superheating. Okay, see, the entomologist, they experimentally prove that the temperature above 140 degree Fahrenheit to 150 degree Fahrenheit for a longer time, which is not good, and the insect they get die. Okay, within 3 hours. And if the duration which is just prolonged, all the stages of the insects, okay, they get killed. So this superheating is also the second alternative, which is also good. And in absence of the use of chemical, we can use this method to killing the different types of the insect pest. Then the third method is there. We call it as the radiation. See here, different types of radiations are there. We are using the radiant energy, and this use of the radiant energy is the new approach of killing or controlling the insect. Now here we are again use the different types of the radiation. For example, see the radio frequency waves, infrared, then visible light and ultraviolet, then ionizing radiation, for example, gamma rays and the X-rays. Okay, so these are the different types of the radiations we are used for controlling or just killing the insect. So the first one, first type of radiation we will study, that is the radio frequency wave. Okay, so in case of the radio frequency waves, we are using the radio communication. Okay, now here used in the development of radio communication, radar, navigation, so these medical fields. So these are the different types of the field where these radio frequency waves are used, and here also we are using these technology of radio frequency waves to killing the insect. Now the heating. Actually, the radio frequency waves, they are responsible for increase the temperature. Okay, and due to that, what happens? See, the heating which kill the pest. So what is happening for in that particular process? See, when the temperature rises, the different types of the physiological changes which are takes place inside the body of the insect pest. So which are those changes? The first one, that is the synaptic blocking. Okay. Then the second one, that is the vacuolization, then coagulation of the nervous system, or change in the amino acid content. So all these changes, they are only occur inside the body of the insect pest without damaging the food grain or without damaging the seeds. Okay, in which we are interested means what? Our food grain remains safe and only the insect get killed. So here the radio frequency hitting, which is the energy dose, and it depends on the species. Okay, so specifically it is depend on the species of insect. It just changes from species to species, as well as it is dependent on the stage in the insect. Okay, so this is about the radio frequency waves. Okay, so the second type of the radiation we will study, that is the infrared. Okay, so infrared, that is in short known as IR. So here we study the IR. Okay, so here in case of the infrared or IR, see it is just act as an intermediate between the radio frequency and visible length. Okay, we will just later on study what is the visible length. But the infrared is the intermediate between the radio frequency waves and the visible light or visible length. Okay, so here infrared radiation, which is actually exposure of the material to the IR energy, will bring about the rise in the temperature of the body of the insects to a particular level at which that insect get killed. Means here also the body temperature increases. Okay, now the temperature of the insect's body is increased due to the IR, that is infrared. Actually, what happens when we are using the IR for heating the or for controlling the stored grain pest? So here what happened, we are stored the bulk food grain, and only a particular surface area, suppose this is the godown where the food grain is stored. Okay, but when we are using the IR, those IR having very less permeability or penetrability, and it is not penetrate very easily. And due to that, what happened, only at a particular depth only these IR rays are able to reach. And due to that, the stored grain pest, if they are present here, only that much of the stored grain pest they get killed. Remaining other pests which are present here, because the IR is unable to penetrate the food grain and reach up to this area. And since whatever the insect pests which are present here in this area, only those pests they get killed. So this is the limitation for the IR. Okay, now we study the next, that is the third one, visible light and ultraviolet. Okay, so visible light means what? See, we are able to observe the color ranges, and the color range is from violet to red. And if you just measure the wavelength, it is about 380 to 770 nanometer. Okay, but the insects, they are only able to observe the 253 to 270 nanometer wavelength. Okay, and this much of region is most effective for attracting the insects. And since we are using this much of spectrum, light spectrum, to attract the insects, and by attracting them, we are going to kill them. Specifically, we are using the visible light in the three ways for controlling the pest. By producing the phototaxis, means what? See, actually phototaxis means here we are using the light, and that light is responsible either for attracting the insects. Suppose this is the light source. So some of the insects, they get attracted towards that light source, and when they get attracted, we are going to kill them. And negatively means what? Due to the light, the insect, they just go away from that particular area. So that is the negative, means they just repel from the light. So the same effect, phototaxis, whether it is positive, means whether it is attracted towards the light, or whether the insects, they repel from the light. Both the types of techniques we can use here for controlling the insect pest. Okay, so this is the first one, how we are going to use the visible light. Then secondly, by inducing the dipause. So dipause means what? It is a one type of pause. See, pause means what? We are going to stop that particular whatever the thing is there, we are going to just pause it at that moment. Okay, for example, see, if you are watching any video, and suppose some guests, they came to you, at that time you are going to pause that video. Okay, and after few minutes or after some time, you are going to restart it. So the video just start from the movement onwards. Okay, so that is known as a pause. So here also what happened due to the light energy, the or photo period is there actually, and due to the change in the photo period, it is just affect on the development of the insect. So some of the insect, they just shows the dipause if the photo period get change. Photo period means what? The duration of the day and night. During the day, see, during summer season, the day is or we can say that for 10 hours we get the light. Okay, during the summer season, and during the winter season we get only the light for only 6 hours. So this is a change in the photo period. So when the change in the photo period occurs, it affects on the dipause. Since there are some insects who undergo the process of dipause in the winter season when the light is available for a short duration, so that is known as a dipause. So dipause means what? If suppose the insect is present in the larval stage, it is remain in that stage only. Okay, if they are in the pupal stage, they remain in the pupal stage only. They will not shows the growth further, or they will not show the further development. They remain as it is. They remain live, but they remain in that particular stage only. म्हणजे ज्या स्टेजला विंटर सीझन मध्ये ते आहे, भले मग ते एग्ज असू दे, लार्वा असू दे, प्युपा, ते त्याच स्टेजला राहतात. दे डू नॉट शो इन इट फर्दर डेव्हलपमेंट. सो दॅट इज नोन ॲज अ डायपोज. सो वी आर विथ द हेल्प ऑफ द फोटो पिरियड, वी कॅन by changing the photo period, we can induce the dipause artificially also. Okay, then the next one, the by modifying the behavior and the ovipositional habit of the insects. See, every insect having its own behavior, and they having their own style of deposition of the egg, and this photo period which affect on the ovipositional habit of the insect, or it is just responsible for changing in the behavior of the insect. So by altering the visible, by using the visible light and UV, we are going to alter the particular behavior and oviposition habit of the insect. So in this way, with the help of visible light and UV, we are going to control the population of insects. And the last type of the radiation, which is known as the ionizing radiation. So in case of ionizing radiation, it is of two type, X-rays, and the second one, that is the gamma rays. So X-rays and gamma rays, both the rays which are responsible for controlling the insect pest. As the X-rays, they are directly lethal. They produces the lethal action. Lethal action means what? They are responsible, X-rays and gamma rays, they are responsible for killing the insect. That is known as the lethal action. And sometimes, if these X-rays and gamma rays, they are unable to kill the insect, but another way they affect on them. How? These X-rays or gamma rays, they are able to induce the sterility, means they in the insects become sterile. Sterile means what? They are unable to laid the eggs, or they are unable to produce the gametes, because both male and females are there. So both the types of the insects, they are unable to produce their gametes, and when they are unable to produce their gamete, there is no further generation. Okay, and this is the way how we are going to control the population of the insects, either by killing them or by making them sterile. Okay, so these are the two ways when we are using the X-rays and gamma rays, the insects, they either die or the sterility is produces. Okay, so ionizing radiation, here X-rays and gamma rays are there. Okay, and the last one, okay, the fourth one, low temperature, superheating, radiation is the third. Radiation possesses all these four radio frequency waves, infrared, visible light and UV, and ionizing radiation. And now the fourth one, that is the sound energy. Okay, so here we are using the sound energy for controlling the pest. Actually, here we are able to use the specific type of devices for frightening to the vertebrates, vertebrate pest, like the birds, monkey, okay, and we are going to control them, and we got the success. In case of insects also, the sound is effective in controlling the boring insect of wood due to the effect of the vibration on the tissues. The insects, they are unable to bore in the wood. Means we are able to control the vertebrate pest also, and along with the vertebrate pest, we can use the sound energy for controlling the insect pest also, specifically the insects which are bore in the wood. ओके लाकडावरती ज्याचा ज्या पेस्टचा इफेक्ट होतो ओके त्या पेस्टसाठी आपण हे यूज करू शकतो साऊंड एनर्जी. सो दीज आर द फोर डिफरंट टाइप्स ऑफ द फिजिकल मेजर्स. हियर वी आर यूजिंग द टेम्परेचर इन द फर्स्ट टू, लो टेम्परेचर, हाय टेम्परेचर. द थर्ड वन इज रिलेटेड विथ द रॅडिएशन, अँड रॅडिएशन इन्क्लूड्स दीज फोर: radio frequency waves, infrared, visible light and UV, and ionizing radiation. And the last one, here we are using the sound energy. Okay, so this is about the physical measures. Now in the next video, we will study about the mechanical measures. Thank you.